We're happy to have Medline come into Tangipahoa Parish and Hammond in general. We are looking at right now a current unemployment rate in Tangipahoa Parish of about 9.7%. And looking at the jobs that Medline's going to be bringing in, which is a great starting salary in our area because it's about $6,000 to $7,000 more than the current individual average salary. We're happy to have Medline here because they meet two of our four demand areas in workforce, which are construction, transportation, and warehousing.
Well, Luke Letlow continues on what must be the world's longest campaign trail for the 5th Congressional District. It runs all the way from here, we're in A-Meet, of course, in front of parish government, but all the way up to the Arkansas state line and all points in between. So after a day of campaigning, how many shoes have you worn out?
Look, I've worn through the soles of my boots, so I can tell you I've had them resold three or four times. But that's what it takes, getting out, talking to people. And I love being here in the Florida parishes.
So I know you've been to Washington Parish. That's in the district as well. What are you hearing?
So obviously I was in Washington Parish today, and I heard a lot of support. You know, people are aware that there's an election on Saturday. A lot of folks didn't early vote, but they're telling me they're going to get out and vote on Saturday. So I'm encouraged by that. And today we had a great visit with the sheriff there. Got to meet with a vast number of people, you know, earlier prior to that. So we're just working hard, getting out and talking to people.
Well, you work in Congress, and you're actually the former aide to Congressman Ralph Abraham, who's endorsed you in this effort to succeed him. But you've done a lot of work on agriculture. And I wonder, is there any hope for our beleaguered dairy farmers, the few that are left, actually, and the rest of agriculture in our area?
You know, I'm well aware of the issues we've got with our dairy farmers. They've got some significant challenges, with some of the dairy that's produced in other states at just a lower cost. But I'll continue to go to fight for our dairy farmers, make sure that they have a voice. If I'm allowed to be on the Agricultural Committee, then I will certainly be in a great position to advocate, you know, to preserve that important commodity right here in the district where you do it so well.
But it just seems that the bigger states, California even, they always get the better of us.
Well, that's where we've got to be smart here in Louisiana. You know, California has 40 to 50 congressmen. We've got 6 here in Louisiana. So what I plan to do is I want to work with our delegation, everybody from New Orleans, all the way up to Shreveport, combine our voices and make sure our voice is heard when it comes to issues just like dairy.
Well, as the makeup of Congress becomes a little more certain, especially on the House side, what role do you see for yourself with narrow Democratic majority there?
Look, at the end of the day, I want to work with everybody to help this district, but I'm proud. We've got a diverse group who've been elected in the freshman class here. We've got a record number of women, got a record number of minorities. I had a great conversation with Congressman Cedric Richmond of New Orleans, who has just been tapped to go work for potential President Joe Biden. So I think I'll have a great relationship in the White House. At the end of the day, you know, I'm not going up to Washington just to argue, to fight one side or the other. I'm going up there to do work and to get things done.
So you're obviously in a runoff, and I don't know how many people even know that Saturday is an election day, and that's got to be the story, which is namely getting your vote out with a very low turnout expected.
You're exactly right. Look, there's been a 90% drop-off in the number of people who have voted in that first election up until right now. So I would encourage everybody to get out and vote on Saturday, December 5th. Proud today to announce, too, 3 of my opponents actually all came together and endorsed me, Democrat and Republican. Alan Guillory, Matt Hastie, and Philip Snowden all have come out today to endorse me. The reason they're picking me as their candidate is because they know I'll listen and I'll go to work for everyone in Louisiana's 5th District.
So what do you do the last couple of days in the campaign?
Look, I will go out and I'll talk anywhere 2 or more are gathered. And, you know, the Florida parishes, as you know, Ken, I love to be here. I love talking to people. I want people to be tired of seeing me in this part of the district because it's so important that you know you've got a representative here. Lastly, I'll add this. I intend to make sure we have a congressional office here in the Florida parishes. And I wouldn't be surprised to see it right here in A-Meet, Louisiana. That's right in the middle of St. Francisville and Bogalusa. Certainly, if I'm successful, I think you'll see that happen.
So let's go up the line and try to describe the district. It goes from here up to the Monroe area and beyond that.
It does. Look, I don't like to ever refer to this as a North Louisiana district or a Northeast Louisiana district. I often correct people when they say that. It's a rural Louisiana district. That's what makes Washington Parish a lot like Morehouse Parish, where you got Bastrop to Bunkie to Bogalusa. I'm excited to go tell the story of what I think are the parts of this state that are sometimes forgotten. And I'm proud to represent it as the next congressman, and we'll go to work to make sure everyone has a voice.
So the smart money is that a natural conciliator like Joe Biden will try to do infrastructure, and if he does, he'll certainly get support across the aisle. Is there hope finally for the Zachary Taylor Parkway? Speaking of rural Louisiana, it would seem to run throughout your district, just about.
You're exactly right. Look, I'm the only candidate that knows what the Zachary Taylor Parkway even is. So I'm certainly going to take that on day one as we look at infrastructure legislation that will spend dollars here in the district, connecting, you know, the east from the west, and also some hurricane evacuation routes that go from the south to the north. Finally, infrastructure dollars need to be spent on rural broadband. As I've said before, in the 1950s, we had President Eisenhower investing in interstate highways. The internet is the highway of today, and we need to make sure we're getting our fair share.
Any thought about the vaccination process that very soon the federal government is going to spearhead?
Look, I think that's good. I think we need to make sure that we're leading the world in terms of research and how do we solve the problem in terms of COVID, making sure we've got investments in our pharmaceutical research and having that vaccine produced. I'm not scared to be one of the first people to sign up and take it. You know, I've been fortunate not to have COVID, but I have confidence we've got some of the smartest, most brilliant people in the world who are in charge of our research, and I'm going to put myself forward to somebody that'll take that step right out of the box.
Well, there is a growing consensus that lockdowns were not an effective way to fight this virus. Where would you come down on that issue if, for example, the Biden administration wants more of a lockdown?
Look, I believe we have to make sure our economy is open, number one. The COVID, you know, pandemic has been a tragedy, and we've seen it make an impact almost on every family in the state and all parts of the country. But we can't have two disasters. We cannot have an economy that collapses as a result of COVID. So we've got to be smarter. At the end of the day, we've got to make sure we're wearing our mask. We got to make sure we're giving people distance. And we got to listen. Everyone that thinks it's a hoax, I think we're all clear. It's not a hoax. It's a real virus that can definitely impact your lives. But we got to walk and chew gum at the same time. We got to make sure our economy doesn't collapse as well.
What about a federal mask mandate, a nationwide mask mandate, which has been discussed?
I don't believe we need a federal mandate telling us to wear a mask because I believe in freedom. At the end of the day, I think you got to have personal responsibility and a personal choice. I always wear a mask, and I encourage everyone to wear a mask, but I don't believe that a federal order to do so is appropriate. How would you enforce that, number one? I think that would be very difficult from a federal level, so I would not support that.
So what are the main things that you're asked about when you press the flesh over such a wide area in Louisiana?
Jobs, jobs, jobs. Jobs is the answer. You may say, like I say, what can a congressman do? I'll tell you, there's a lot a congressman can do. Number one, he can work for the governor, Democrat or Republican, and I intend to do that. Number two, he can go to Washington and incentivize investments all across this district into the most impoverished areas. Opportunity tax credits is a great example, where we bring in investors from other states to invest right here in this 5th district.
You remind me a lot of a guy that I'm sure you know. His name is Garrett Graves,
yeah.
And he's the congressman, I think, in the 6th district over in the Baton Rouge area, concentrating on local issues, concentrating on infrastructure, working with Governor Edwards, and totally result-oriented in terms of bringing home big drainage projects and road projects. And he's been, I think, very successful.
I consider Garrett Graves a mentor and also a big brother. He's been extremely helpful to me. He has mentored me in this race. He has certainly had a similar background that I do. Worked in Congress before, worked in the state government before. You know, we were the guys that worked behind the scenes to get things done. Now, I think it's my chance to step forward and do some of the great things just like Garrett Graves has done. And together, we'll be smarter for this state. We'll make sure we get results in everything we do.
What else do you want to share with us?
Look, if nothing else is remembered today, I would just ask you to please, please vote on Saturday, December 5th. I'm Luke Letlow. I'm a Christian. I'm a husband. I'm a father. And I want your vote. I'm here in Tangipahoa Parish today. I'll be back often. And I thank everyone that actually early voted for me already in this election.
But it's down 90%.
Down 90%, Ken. We've got to have people to go vote. December 5th, Saturday. Everybody needs to vote.
Medline means jobs for Hammond. Medline anticipates creating 450 jobs in Hammond when the distribution center is at full capacity. The project will create another 300 construction jobs as it is built. This family-owned, debt-free company's proposed investment in Hammond will generate approximately $400 million in economic activity for our region over a decade, including an estimated $1.5 million spent annually with local Hammond area businesses for services and building maintenance. For more information, please visit MedlineHammond.com.